towards the analysis of movement variability in human-humanoid imitation activities, presented by Miguel Tsochikale, PhD student, and Chris Weber, my supervisor, from the Department of Electronic, Electrical and System Engineering at the University of Birmingham in the UK. Introduction. Movement variability is an inherent feature within a person and between persons' movements. Due to the complexity of human motion activities and the multidimensional variables that are involved in such activities, the use of the nonlinear dynamics invariants based on the state-space reconstruction have been proved to be reliable techniques for a better insight of movement variability. In this work, we have found that there is little research in the area of human robot interaction where quantification of movement variability requires to be reliable for the creation of better models of interaction and for more realistic scenarios of interaction where the motion capture systems are usually expensive, invasive, or take a long time preparation calibration. Methods. State-space reconstruction theorem. The purpose of the state-space reconstruction theorem is to reconstruct an unknown m-dimensional state space, which is represented by this figure, from a one-dimensional measurement function xt, which is represented by 1b, and the theorem is based on m-delay copies of xt, which are uniformly separated by tau, and the theorem is also known as time delay embedding because of these delay copies of the xt, and is defined by this equation, which is a matrix, and m and tau are the embedding parameters. So this is the unknown m-dimensional space, which can be reconstructed by using only xt, and is represented in this 3D reconstructed state space. The experiment. In the experiment, we ask 18 participants to imitate what the robot does, and we attach inertial sensors to the robot and to the wrist of the persons. We also use a webcam to estimate the head pose using open face framework. So participant, let's say one, imitate what the robot does, or mirror what the robot does as closer as he or she can do it. So for the results, what we got is this time series, that we collect from the head pose estimation from the open face framework, this time series for the inertial sensor attached to the left wrist and to the right wrist. Then what we did is to compute the reconstructed state space using m equal to 100 and tau equal to 4. So we use this time series in order to get this reconstructed state space, which is shown here for participant 1, 4, 12, using again the open face framework, left wrist sensor and right wrist sensor. It's important to highlight that participant 4, the head of participant 4 was in synchronization with the movement of the heads, which is a bit different from what happens to all of the participants, because for example participant 1 was, the head of participant 1 was a bit static as it was Nao's head, because Nao's head was always static. But on the other hand, participant 12 was kind of static for a certain period, and then he or she moves their head for a while, which was a bit variable. And those behaviors can be seen in these two state space reconstruction. Another important thing that I want to highlight is that participant 12, that the movements of the arms for participant 12 were different. So you can see that this circle was slightly smaller than this one, which is for the right wrist. So participant 12 was not really good in imitating what the robot does, and participant 4 for the head pose estimation, we kind of clearly observe that he moved or she moved his or her head according to this, to the state space reconstruction. Then in order to quantify this, what we did is to compute the Euclidean distances between the 0.00 to each of the points from the trajectories of this to the space reconstruction. So what we got is the following box whiskey plots. So all that you see here is all these points which are computed by the Euclidean distances. And these results are for the open face framework for the head pose estimation for participant 1 to 18. And then I highlight this is for participant 1, 4, and 12. This is for the left wrist sensor for participant 1 to 18, highlighting participant 1 to 1, 4, and 12. And this is for sensor in the attached to the right wrist for participant 1 to 18, highlighting participant 1, 4, and 12. It's important to observe that participant 12, that the movements of the arms of participant 12 were different. So it can be observed by looking this point and or this area of data, which is different in the scale. Is this one is around 4 and this one is like 6 or 6.5. That happens also with participant 6, which is 3.5 for right wrist and 5 for left wrist. And in the case of head pose estimation, participant 4 was in synchronization with the arm movements, which can be seen with this one. And that behavior also happened to participant 17. And the other participants were quite ecstatic, were like participant 12 or participant 1. So to conclude, we not only presented visual differences of movement variability for arms and head pose between 18 participants, but also we quantify such movement variability using the state space reconstruction theorem. Considering that the participants were young and healthy subjects, we found that we can quantify that participants 6 and 12 did not imitate nouns movements well, since their arms moved asymmetrically. And participants 4 and 17 moved their head while nouns head was static. With this in mind, we believe that such levels of humanoid imitation are promising for applications in rehabilitation, sports science, entertainment, or education. In future experiments, we intend to investigate firstly the variability of motions and emotions in one-to-one and one-to-many human-humanoid interactions. Secondly, the exploration of more complex movements. Thirdly, the collection of data from a wider range of individuals. Fourthly, the application of deep learning techniques for the automatic classification of the movement variability.